For today, our topic is gastrointestinal bleeding. We divide gastrointestinal bleeding into two types, upper GI bleeding, lower GI bleeding. In this video, I will talk about upper GI bleeding. We will discuss lower GI bleeding in my next video. So now, in upper GI bleeding, the source of blood is proximal to ligament of teres, which sends blood to the stomach, and in stomach it causes hematemesis. Hematemesis is vomiting of blood, which shows coffee ground emesis. With hematemesis and coffee ground emesis, blood exposed to stomach acid. Here it forms melena, which is dark black tarry stools. Now, rarely it forms hematochasia. Hematochasia is blood in stool. It happens when blood directly moves towards rectum and when melena is not formed. Now here it's duodenum. We can see ligament. So proximal to ligament is upper GI bleeding, and distal to ligament we can call it lower GI bleeding. In upper we have melena formation. Here we have some causes. Any process which erodes mucosa cause GI bleeding. First, peptic ulcer disease, erosive gastritis, erosive esophagitis, esophageal or gastritis varices or vessels, portal hypertension, gastropathy. So these are some causes of upper GI bleeding. So now we will talk about general management of GI bleeding. First, two large bore 16 gauge IVs, then we use IV fluid and stabilize the patient. After this, blood transfusion criteria, we follow this. If patient is severely bleed, so here for young and low risk patient, we have a cutoff less than 8 mg per deciliter. For older and comorbid patient, we have a cutoff less than 9 mg per deciliter. And for variceal bleeds, we have criteria less than 7 mg per deciliter. And also platelet transfusion, if platelets is less than 50k. So here fresh frozen plasma or prothrombin complex for coagulopathy. For transfusion we must see hemoglobin and hematocrit. Here in general management we must check complete blood count, also platelets and prothrombin, PTT, INR, and also type and screen because of blood transfusion. Now here we do upper endoscopy, other tests like angiography, capsule endoscopy, deep small bowel enteroscopy, push or push enteroscopy. Now in medical management we use intravenous proton pump inhibitor to reduce acidity, and we mostly use in all upper GI bleeds. We use octreotide to variceal bleeding, and also for the constriction of arterioles and to decrease the portal flow. We use octreotide, and we also use antibiotics in the case of cirrhosis and bleeding, and up to 20% develop infection, then we use antibiotics, and also shown to decrease re-bleeding, and here we also use antibiotics. So by this way we manage upper GI bleeding.